Hi, I'm Johnathan Bowman and welcome. This is a short clip put together to show you how we run our business and how I make my living. There's no combination of words I could put on the back
of a postcard. No song. People often ask me whether I wanted to do horses as a living when I was younger, and I, to be quite honest, I don't think I would have done. It's just the way that life took me. Yes, I did the ponies, jumped a horse the year show, represented my country on many an occasion, then moved on to horses, jumped at Olympia Young Riders, went through the graded from novice up to grade A, then started teaching people, went to talent and did my AI, did my BSJ UKCC level 3, and the teaching has got bigger and bigger as the years have gone on. I've got my academy as well, which is growing all the time. But also, the horses are getting better, more owners, and it's just going to keep going, growing and growing from there, really. So this is how I ended up where I am now. Yeah, it's always better when we're together.
I'd like to think I've got a good business now. I've got a lot of pupils that I teach, a lot of up and coming horses that I'm competing. And yes, when you start off in horses as a career, you have to ride whatever comes your way. I've rode some horses that I haven't liked to ride. I've rode some horses that I've had my heart broken when they've been taken off of me. That's the horse industry, really. But now I'm in a position where I've got new owners, new horses. I've got a string of horses coming up from behind. I've got foals up through to 4-year-olds, 5-year-olds. I think the oldest horse we've got now is probably 7-year-old. And then we've got the old stager Marcel, which is part of the family. He's coming up 15 now. We've had him since a 3-year-old. He still jumps a lot of the bigger classes, but we just pull him out for when we need him. And then obviously put him away once he's done his job. We won't look to sell him now. He's part of the family and he'll probably retire in the field when his day comes. Yeah, it's always better when we're together. Why do I buy young horses? It's quite simple, really. I can't afford the good ones. So I have to buy them at an age where people don't really know what they've got. And hopefully one of them will turn out really good. When they get to 7 or 8 year old, that's when they're at their prime. And obviously people can see what they have to offer. And if they're very good, obviously I can't afford them. So this is the reason why I buy young ones. I obviously buy foals all the way through up. So I've got a good string of horses coming behind me. When I look at my horses, I look at breeding, the stallion, the mother. Mother line is very important. But also whether I like the animal. You must have to like the animal to put 100% effort in from you. And the most important thing is that it needs to have 100% trainability. You can't train it, you can't get the most out of it. When I'm not competing or riding at home, I travel around teaching others, schooling horses, or training from the floor. I feel everybody from the floor needs a set of eyes to pick up advice on, to point out whether the horse is jumping in the correct manner, whether the horse is riding in the correct manner, and if not, try and advise how to improve the animal. This is a huge part of my business, and I have a very wide range of clientele, one of the youngest being 6, and one of the oldest being 66. I do a lot of training on a weekly and fortnightly basis, and I feel that everybody gains from this. But I can try for your heart and our dreams, and they are made out of real. Connected to my teaching, I also run the JB Academy. It's entering its 5th year now, and it's gone from strength to strength. It's run on a yearly basis with structured monthly training. Some months it may be workshop activities, other months it might be grid work, stroke pole activities, moving on to jumping a course. We vary each venue we go to, so each person gets the opportunity to ride at different places, so they're not just schooling at home. The age group have ranged from 6-year-olds up to seniors, and like I say, it's very, very popular, and it's grown from strength to strength, and it's something that's going to be around for a long, long time. Yeah, it's always better when we're together. Where do I see my business going from here? Well, firstly, I think the teaching side of it is very, very strong, and it's going from strength to strength, and the numbers are getting bigger and bigger. So I can see myself carrying on to do that for many years to come. I'd like to think from my show jumping side of things, I can get my syndicate and my investments going further, so more and more horses come my way, get better and better quality of animal. Yes, I like to buy a few of my own, but I also like to get owners on board as well, so to spread the risk and everyone can enjoy the experience. But if all of these dreams might find their way into my
day-to-day scene, I do hope you've enjoyed this short clip, and it's given you an insight to what we get up to in the business. I'd like to think myself and my team are very approachable, so if there's anything we can help you with, no matter how big or how small, please feel free to pick the telephone up so we can discuss the matter further. You can also follow us on Facebook and YouTube, where you can see what we're getting up to with the horses, what our sponsors are offering, and also training videos. These give you a little bit of help so you can do these at home, how to set them up, and what it will do to practice with your horse and how it will improve it. Also, if you see us at the shows, please feel free to come up and say hello. Like I say, we're here to help you no matter how big or how small the matter is.